lot of the discussions that they had focused on things like equal rights, the opportunity for girls to have an equal education, child laborers, and there were a lot of fruitful discussions about local issues like bullying.
I'm a very talkative person, so going silent and being involved and knowing so many people, I think seeing someone in the hallway just have that natural instinct to say like hi or just talk to them.
I thought about them and I thought about how they don't get to be heard, their stories aren't heard, and I thought, well, what I have to say isn't as important as what they have to say, so I'm going to be quiet for them.
It's like people you see in the hallway who are silent, they need help, but no one listens to them.
Like, I was able to be in like their position for a day, and it was hard.
It was actually very interesting to see kids tackle the same assignment with and without voice, especially in a drama class.
What I had my students do for Vow of Silence was we had prepared an art project. It was hard for us at first, and there was, you know, some anxiety and some confusion.
So a lot of them became frustrated that they couldn't communicate, and I think that caused them to reflect how lucky they are that they can communicate when there is something that they need. And it caused them to reflect on people in society and other places in the world who don't have a voice like they do.
You can be angry from that, frustrated, you can be sad, depressed, to have a whole variety of feelings from that, and they agreed that, you know, that certainly that they didn't like that.
And I think that showed them how in our education system you can ask questions, whereas there are other places that you can't.
It made me have to think about the things I take for granted on a day-to-day basis. It definitely made the teaching slower. I think there was another lesson to be learned during that process.
You see things that you normally wouldn't see. You hear things that you normally wouldn't hear.
I thought to myself that I'm just doing this for a day, and there's people in the world that are doing it every single day of their lives.
It taught me how to put myself in other people's shoes and look from a different perspective.
We tend to talk and talk and talk, and we forget to listen to other people and to reflect on like what's happening in the world.
I learned that we're really fortunate and that we can express ourselves and speak out against things that are unjust towards us, and that we need to do that for others.
You shouldn't be using your freedom of speech to bully other people. It should be a way to give thanks and to encourage people in a positive manner.
I learned that there is hope for anyone that is going through tough times, because there are people like us that are noticing that. We're reaching out and saying we're here for you.